Hello, Mr. Niren here. Welcome to Rise of Valyria Total War, a mod by Peaman, creator of Game of Thrones Total War, Fire and Blood. It was originally a continuation of Game of Thrones Enhanced, but turned into its own mod. So this mod, Rise of Valyria, is a new mod. He decided to not just work on Fire and Blood, a mod based on Game of Thrones Total War, of course, with 14 different campaigns set in different time periods. This mod, Rise of Valyria, is set 9,000 or more years before Game of Thrones. You can compare that to the prequel series that will come in a year or so, about the Targaryens. It's set, I believe, during the, I believe the, either it's Robert's Rebellion or it's earlier, but I'm not sure if it was a Targaryen Civil War or if it was Robert's Rebellion, I'm not sure. But that prequel series takes place before the show, before Game of Thrones, and I believe it's set 100 years earlier. This mod is set 9,000 years earlier, so it's way, way earlier. Okay, let's check game settings. It says it should good. I knew it would be. I've already recorded this once, but then I realized it wasn't recorded. Something was wrong because he had Bandicam on as well, so the game didn't record for some reason. They wasted like an hour speaking without recording. Okay, so we have all the settings at max. That's good, and we do not need the widescreen. So this menu looks a lot like the old menu for Battle for Middle Earth or Battle for Middle Earth 2. So it's probably inspired by that menu because it looks exactly like this. The way you have the menu here, when you click multiplayer, for example, you have options here, LAN battles, online battles, hot seat campaign, etc., or single player with all the options. It's exactly like in Battle for Middle Earth and Battle for Middle Earth 2, which is, they are strategy games, more in line with Warcraft 3 or Age of Empires. But the cool thing about Battle for Middle Earth and Battle for Middle Earth 2 was that they went from recruiting one unit to recruiting like battalions. Instead of recruiting one unit each time, you recruited like 9 units or 6 units each time. So it was a big upgrade. Also, you had like powers that where you could summon creatures like the Balrog or eagles, etc. It was a very good game. It was my favorite strategy game before Medieval Total War. I never played Rome Total War back in the day. I missed Rome Total War entirely. So Medieval 2 was the first Total War game that I played, and before I played Medieval 2, I played Battle for Middle Earth and Battle for Middle Earth 2. Okay, but I also played Warhammer 40,000 Soulstorm, another great RTS game from before I played Medieval 2. I started playing Medieval 2 in 27, I believe. Okay. So Rise of Valyria is a mod for Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms, and a sister mod of Game of Thrones Total War Fire and Blood, another mod by Peaman, the creator of this mod. He sent me this mod yesterday, before it's even released. He was I spoke to him about some stuff, and we discussed the update of Game of Thrones Enhanced. I'm planning an update there as well. It's a smaller update, updating the heroes and some other stuff. And then he said he would release this mod, Rise of Valyria, in a month or so. But he said he wanted to fix the text, the descriptions of the factions, the descriptions of the units, etc. And he wanted to add some more stuff to it, so it won't be released yet. But that's why we are so surprised that he sent it to me. So he sent the mod to me, but it won't be released in a while because he wanted to improve it. He probably wanted me to preview it and test it out and give him feedback. Okay, the other mod, Fire and Blood, is also getting a huge update. So version 2.2 of that mod has been out since, I believe, September, October 2020. That's the official release. And then in April or something this year, he released a Discord alpha or beta of version 2.3, which added a bunch of new custom strat models and new models in battle and such, even new UI and improvements to the campaign, bug fixes and such. And that's been around since April on the Discord for the mod, but he has worked on that update since then as well, and he said he will release the real version 2.3 on ModDB this weekend, either tonight or tomorrow night. And the difference in that version is that it adds a bunch of custom settlements cities. So there will be a bunch of custom settlements in the mod that he has made himself. He didn't make the models, they were of course borrowed but from other games, but he has done a huge amount of work on importing the models and and making them work in the game and texturing them and doing all kinds of work in the EVTE program. I hear though that the EVTE program has been updated recently by Maca Jane, and that now it's easier to work with it. Previously it was harder, more difficult, and now they have added an automatic feature which automates a certain process in the creation of custom settlements, so it's faster. But I have no doubt that it's still a lot of work to do it. I don't know how to do it, but I have never tried either. Okay, so this mod, Rise of Valyria, I got an early alpha or beta. So it has all the strat models, it has all the agents, it has all the battle models, but of course Peaman will probably add more as time goes by. I don't believe he is finished with the faction units. He might be finished with the units of the first release of the version 9.0 alpha, but he will probably add more stuff as time goes by. Okay, I don't know about custom cities, but this mod do not have any custom cities. It has strat models, custom strat models on the map, including city models on the map, but it doesn't have any custom models in battle yet, because Peaman is currently working on Fire and Blood and adding that to the Fire and Blood mod. Okay, and we will check out the custom battles like I were doing when I realized that it wasn't recording. So we can see here that Era 2 and 3 have NA here, so I don't believe we can use them. Specials, usually this is the all section where all the units are available. We will go for the Fire and Blood one. Probably needs a new name, Rise of Valyria maybe or something, no idea. But anyway, we will check the factions. So here we have the Yogos Nai Source Lords, and we have the city-states of Sarnor. So city-states, it reminds me of like the Greek states of the antiquity. And then we have the God King Ibn. Oh, I shouldn't replace the faction, we need to click there, and then God King Ibn. We have the Princes of the Summer Islands, so I believe the Song of Ice and Fire Italian mod also have this faction playable. So it's a bunch of isles between the Martell lands and Essos. Okay, and then we have Shadow Lord of Ashai, so faction. We have God Emperor of GT. And we have Kingdom of Andals and the city-states of Mother Roin. Let's check them. So you can see that the roster of the Yogos Nai Source Lords is not the largest or biggest roster. They are completely unique units that I've never seen before. I know that Peaman is also a part of the Third Age Reforged team, where he has at least made a bunch of strat models for the team. Unique family members and such. So he's a part of that mod, that's why he has access to some battle models from Third Age Reforged, which he has reskinned and edited and remade for some of the units in this mod. So some of the units in these rosters might be based on units from Third Age Reforged, but not all of them. And some of them are based on the units from Fire and Blood, which are in turn the same units as in, or used to be the same units as in Game of Thrones Enhanced, but now maybe in version 2.3 they have been remade to make them more unique. They have new parts and different textures and such, but in the old 2.2 version they were pretty much the same units. Okay, and then we can check the next faction. This isn't a big faction, it's one of the smaller factions in the game. We have the Shadow Lord of Ashai with a huge faction roster. Really cool faction. I could actually play this faction because I think their units look dope. Okay, the catapult here is from Dibellomundi, or DBM, a Italian mod for Medieval Total War Kingdoms, set in the antiquity, and based on like Romans and such. I believe that these siege engines are in the mod because they were in Fire and Blood, and this mod is, I believe Peaman based this mod on his Fire and Blood mod, which in turn was based on Westeros 1.0. Okay, and Fire and Blood aimed to at first be the continuation of Game of Thrones Enhanced, so that's why Peaman added the models from Enhanced to Fire and Blood and the siege engines. That's why it has the siege engines from Fire and Blood that I added originally in 2017, I believe. So they look better than the vanilla siege engines, but they are not good because they, at least if you play on a Macintosh or Mac, you don't want these in the game because the unique ballista, catapult, and onager of Dibellomundi, used by the old Game of Thrones Enhanced mod and Fire and Blood, and by extension this mod, they cause the mod to not start on a Macintosh or a Mac computer. So if you want to play on a Macintosh or a Mac, you can't have these siege engines in the game. By removing them, it should work, but there is one exception. If you have custom cities or settlements, they too will cause the same problem. So you can't have custom cities in the game either, if you want it to work on a Mac. But there is one exception to that rule, because I read on Total War Center that there is a way to enable custom cities for Macintosh as well. But it required some work, and I have never done that work, so I don't know how to do it. The easiest way to make a mod work on a Mac is to remove custom siege engines and remove custom cities, then they will work on Mac. But there is another way of making the mod work, and that required some modding that I have never done, so I can't really explain the procedure, but there were a tutorial on Total War Center, the main modding site for Medieval Total War and other Total War games. Okay, so this faction is pretty cool, with a big number of units, all looking very unique and different. I also like the color black, dark color. So the Ashai faction, yeah, they had some, isn't that the faction with the red priests? I'm not sure. Anyway, we did hear about Ashai in Game of Thrones, so okay. Then we have the city-states of Sarnor, another faction with a big roster, really cool units. I like them too, both cavalry and infantry. Okay, and then we have the God Emperor of YT, Chinese inspired Asian troops. They look very Chinese, but unique. And yeah, I think they are pretty cool. Large roster, bringing Asians to the table. Okay, God King of Ibn. These guys look like Vikings with Viking helmets and such. I like that. It's not the biggest roster, so they are a smaller faction. The Ibn Mammoths lack their unit card, otherwise they seem to have all their cards and such. So they have mammoths, that's cool. Like the Vilings. Okay, Kingdom of Andals, another small faction but with really cool units. Okay, and the fourth group, we have the Princes of Summer Islands, and just like in Song of Ice and Fire, they are Africans, supposed to be like African tribes of Westeros, of course. Africa doesn't exist in Westeros, but they are the equivalent of African tribes. But in the Song of Ice and Fire mod, they are just reskinned Aztecs, I believe, reskinned into blacks. But in this mod, they have unique models, so really good to see that. I like unique new models over reskinned vanilla models. So this is the best looking Summer Islands faction I've seen to date. Okay, and then they had a pretty decent faction roster too. Not too small, but not too big either. So decent sized unit roster. I believe this is the size you need for a faction to be 100% worth playing. If you only have one row, it's not enough to be enjoyed properly. But two rows is probably what you need. If it has four rows or three, then of course it's even better. But two rows is usually what I would say is a faction roster. If it's one row, I would call them, I would see them as a minor faction, not intended to be played as, but destroyed. You're supposed to just conquer them then, I think. Okay, and then the next faction, the City-States of Maldoroin, another huge, large faction roster. They look good, I think. Roin. Maybe they are like Martell descendants or something. Desert-looking shields and such, I'm not sure. Or maybe they are a completely different faction. I'm not sure about the past story. I don't know much about the period 9,000 years before the show of Game of Thrones. But it's supposed to be set in the same world as Game of Thrones 9,000 years earlier. Let's back out and check the other factions. You are still recording, I was worried there, I had to check. I hate when I speak for a long time and then realize nothing what was recorded. I have to redo everything. Okay. So the next faction will be the Shadow Prince of the Hidden City. Okay, a very long name. Then we have the God Empress of Leng. We have the Valyrian Freehold, the main faction of this mod. So this mod is obviously about the Rise of Valyria, the forefathers of House Targaryen, that were kind of weak during this time period, but then found the magic required to tame dragons. They also found the dragons and then used their mages to tame them, and with the help of the dragons they could then conquer most of Essos and all of Westeros, I believe. Now I might be wrong, if it was only Westeros they took and not Essos as well. I don't remember, but I think they took both. They ruled most of the world of Ice and Fire. Okay, and they are the forefathers of House Targaryen. Okay, and then we have the Emperor of Great Moraki. No, I don't want to replace Valyrian Freehold. Okay, the Emperor of Great Moraki. Tribe of Sotorius, and we have the Dreadlord of the Bloodless Men, another interesting faction. I believe the Bloodless Men, according to Peaman, based on what I read, they are the forefathers of the others, the undead of the show, what they looked like before they were undead. Okay, and then we have the Kingdom of the Andals. No, not the Kingdom of the Andals. We replaced the Kingdom of the Andals. Okay, we are going to replace them with the Kingdom of Ifequeveron. Okay. Then we have the Pureborn of Kart. Kart, the faction that tried to stab Daenerys in the back. Okay, let's check these factions. We have the Shadow Prince of the Hidden City, with a large roster. Another cool faction. Could also place these guys. They look very badass. Dark-colored evil guys. At least I think they're evil if they look like this. Okay, yeah, I could play as this faction too because I like their aesthetic. Okay, then we have the Tribe of Sotorius, another like tribe of colored people with cool unique models, but not the biggest roster. They have access to siege too. Okay, and then we have the God Empress of Leng, another Chinese-based faction. I like that they have a female unit, laying Empress Blades. So I usually like when there are some variation and not just men everywhere. So the fact that they have a female unit is a good thing. But they are another Asian based faction, now with a god empress instead of a god emperor. Both are probably based on China to some extent. Maybe Japan, I don't know. Okay, Dreadlord of the Bloodless Men. Forefathers of the others. Okay, or at least according to what I read. So they look kinda like Dalians from Third Age with the hats. And are not as cool as I would have expected them to be. And you read that they are Dreadlord of the Bloodless, you think that they would be pale in their skin and be more zombie-like, till they look like just humans. So the name look more badass than the unit, but still a cool faction, a smaller faction can be played. The third group, the Valyrian Freehold faction with the most units probably. Look at this. So they have everything from light, medium to heavy. So like light mace men, medium mace men, and heavy mace men, light swordsmen, and everything else. They have bowmen, longbowmen, and spearmen and such, and they have light, medium, and heavy of all of that. Then they have some other units. They have the Valyrian blood mages, and they have the Valyrian fire mages. They have mages, so an OP faction. And then they have some other stuff like sword masters, steel bowmen, and they even have dragon bodyguard cavalry, mounted dragon lords. They are mounted on horses, of course, and dragon lords dismount as well. They have some dragons, huge dragon, large dragon, small dragon, and monstrous dragon. I haven't checked the difference yet, but they have four different variations of dragons, so really a strong faction, and the main faction of this mod, Rise of Valyria, and this is the Valyrian Freehold. Okay, the forefathers of House Targaryen. So the Kingdom of Ifequeron, another large roster, they look cool as well. No cavalry here, an infantry based faction, with many units. Okay, then the fourth group, Emperor of Great Moraki. It's a medium-sized army. Some of these units, I think, look a bit like... yeah, you can see that they are based on Third Age units. This one, for example, looked like a Dunlending-based unit, like the Freel here. But, yeah, cool faction. We have the Pureborn of Kart, and these three units look a lot like the Varag units from Third Age, or if it's actual Rune units. The others look very unique and different, but I think the colors of these three should be changed, or at least they make me think of Third Age at least. They look like the Rune troops or the Varags of Khan troops. I'm not sure. The Vera unit looked pretty much the same. Okay, maybe there are a lot of edits though. Maybe they are different, but the colors are the same. I mean, maybe the colors shouldn't be as similar. Okay, but the Pureborn of Kart still had a decent sized roster and some really cool units. We're done. We need now to check the other factions. So we have the Peacekeeper of Nat and the Giskari Empire, the dominant faction in this mod, in the campaign, at the start of the campaign. They are the faction that is dominating the world in the beginning, before Valyria rose to power. Okay, and then we have the Dothraki, of course. And the Triarch of Volantis. We have the Magister of the Three Daughters. And we have the Bearded Priests of Narvos. and the Prince of the Confederation and the Magister of Kuhor. I can't see the Bolton symbols. Maybe that faction has a different symbol here. But in the campaign we had the Bolton symbol faction too. They're supposed to be the Frost, House Frost. And then we have Arryn's symbol here and the Martell. They are supposed to be two different factions. Maybe they will get new names later. So we have the Peacekeeper of Nat, another small faction with a tribal unit roster. So another tribe-based faction. We have the Magister of the Three Daughters. They are not in the campaign. They have no units. So they are a free unused faction slot. We have the Iskari Empire, the dominant faction of the mod, as far as I know, after reading about it. Okay, and their units look a bit like the basic and medium troops of the Rune faction in Third Age. These troops look a bit like them, but they are probably based on these units. They even have elephants, and they have some cool units too, unique looking units, including Sons of the Harpy and such. But yeah, they have some rune based units. Okay, so this is the dominant faction in the mod. We have the Bearded Priests of Norvos, another smaller faction. I can clearly see that these guys, the Norvosh heavy pikemen and such bowmen, are based on the, I believe, the Eriador militia troops, and this guy probably on an Aenidweight unit or Dunlending unit. So there are some turret units here with new skins and new, maybe new gear and such. Okay, the Bearded Priests of Norvos. Then group 3, we have the Dothraki. We have two new units, the Blood Riders and the Horse Lords with unique riders. So new models rigged and implemented by Peaman. Then we have the old units, the Horse Archers, Foot Archers, Riders and the Warriors. We can see that they are the same units as in Game of Thrones Enhanced and Fire and Blood, but here they have got the new textures, so they have darker clothes, etc. They have different details, so it's the same unit I believe in at the core it's the same unit, but they have new textures and maybe some gear moved around and such. Okay, so the Draki are in the mod, of course, and they are not one of the big factions. They are have a very small roster. They have one new rider model, two new units. I believe the Blood Riders are the bodyguard, and no, Horse Lord is the bodyguard, and the Blood Riders is an elite unit. Okay, then we have the Prince of the Confederation. They have no units. They are probably not in the campaign. They are another second free slot. We have the Triarch of Volantis, another one that is not in use. We have the Magister of Kuhor with a small faction roster, including some cool troops here. Okay, not the biggest roster. Okay, and that's it. Kuhoric Axeman, Kuhoric Woodsman. Okay, Kuhoric units looked kinda cool. Okay, let's check the final factions now. So we have House Martell, but they will be renamed to something else. And House Arryn, they will be renamed Royce, which is a minor house of House Arryn in Game of Thrones. And this will be another one, a minor house of Martell, probably, that was more potent back in the day. Okay, let's check their units. So the Martell equivalent faction has this small roster. Firstman Bowmen, Firstman Bodyguards, Firstman Champions, and Firstman Clansmen. So they are the first men, the ones that are using the Martell slot. And the Royce faction have same units currently. Okay. We won't check the units in battle. We go immediately to the campaigns. We have two campaigns, Fire and Blood and War of Conquest. I believe that Fire and Blood won't work, but I could be wrong. I think this mod was based on Fire and Blood, that's why there are two campaigns. We'll go for War of Conquest, which is the campaign Rise of Valyria is based on. We will have battle difficulty on medium and campaign difficulty on very hard. Having it on very hard, they will do the best they can in the campaign. Well, in battle, if we have it on hard or very hard, it will just give the AI enemy bonuses in battles, and we don't want that. We can manage all the cities, no time limit, we don't need to throw any CPU moves. It could be a long campaign. So I believe sheets do work, but there are no option here to disable them. Here we have the Bolton faction, they will be House Frost, I believe. And here is the Royce faction. And then we have these two, based on Baratheon and Martell. That will be two other factions that were more prominent during this time. Then we have all the other factions. We can see that up here we have the King of Ibn. I don't dare clicking on all the faction slots, because if I click on these symbols it might crash. Sometimes it will crash if you click on too many. I'm not sure if that's the case here. But we can have the cursor above them. So the God King of Ibn here. We have the King of Ifekveron. Yogos Nine Source Lords here. The Dothraki. We have the City-States of Sarnor. Magister of Kohor, the Bearded Priests of Norvos, Kingdom of Andals, and here we have the City-States of Mother Roin. Okay, and then here we have the Valyrian Freehold. It's a really impressive area. And here we have the Giscari Empire, the dominant faction. The Pureborn of Kart over here, so they are down there, Kart. Here we have the Emperor of Great Moraki. Then we have Tribe of Sotorius here. Peacekeeper of Nat. The Princess of the Summer Islands down here. So they weren't between Martell and Essos, they were beneath Martell. Okay, then we have the God Emperor of GT. And the God Empress of Leng. They border each other. And we have the Shadow Lord of Ashrai down here. Here we have the Shadow Prince of the Hidden City, and here we have the Dreadlord of the Bloodless Men. And that's all the factions. We will check the Valyrians. We can see that some of the factions do not have any faction descriptions yet. Strength, Mighty Dragons. Weakness, Prince to prone to infighting. Okay. Dragon Lords of the Valyrians. Okay. Let's start the campaign. So a completely new UI and faction loading screens. I'm not sure if they are different from Fire and Blood yet, or if they are the same. I haven't played the 2.3 version, especially not tried out the recent one that will be released tonight or tomorrow night, because it hasn't been released. I played a little bit of the 2.3 version released in April. It crashed. That's weird. Because I believe that I could enter it yesterday. I will start up the game again and try to load the campaign. Okay, see ya. Welcome to Rise of Valyria, Total War. We're in the campaign. So I restarted the game. It crashed when I tried to start the campaign. Yesterday it worked fine. Then I tried it now and it crashed. And I restarted the mod and it worked. So I see sometimes it can actually crash when I try to start it. But I believe that was because I had gone into custom battle first without playing a custom battle. So then when I started to tried to start the campaign, it crashed. If I had gone immediately to the campaign, it would have worked. But if you go to the custom battle screen, to the selection screen of custom battle, then you need to start the battle and then return to the menu and then start the campaign. If you go from the custom battle selection screen to the campaign without playing or starting a custom battle, then it will crash when the loading screen finishes. I believe that's the case. Okay, interactive supply lines. There are some scripts in this mod too. I recall this script being in Westeros 1.0 as well. The mod that Fire and Blood was based on, and this mod of course is based on Fire and Blood. Do you wish to play with the interactive supply lines and pillaging system? This will allow for unique ancillaries and bonuses become becomes available while campaigning in enemy territory. Sure. Okay, so we can check out Valyria. This symbol, by the way, looks a lot like the Blood Elven or Sindori symbol of Warcraft, Total War. They have a very similar symbol to the Blood Elves. Okay, like a phoenix of some kind. Or a dragon, maybe. In Warcraft, it's a phoenix. Here, it might be a dragon here. Dragon Flame or something. Okay, capital city, Valyria. Faction leader, Visraenar. Greatest general, Garayar. Celtigar. Generals, 35. They were 35 generals. Regions controlled, 14 at start. We have 7 cities and 7 castles. Battles won 0, battles lost 0. Year is 5000. Turn number 1. Victory condition. We have no real victory conditions. Turns remaining to complete them are 2000. So a long campaign. But Peaman probably still has to add the victory conditions. Okay. Diplomacy. There are no alliances in this mod. Everyone start allied to no one and at war with only the rebels. Okay. So it's a sandbox. You pick one faction and then you can do whatever you want. There are no alliances and no wars in the beginning. Okay. We have completely new strat models for the cities and completely new strat models for the units, heroes, custom characters and agents. So here we have Baymar Aegirion. This is Baymar Aegirion of the Valyrian Freehold. Okay. He is a family member. We have mostly new UI as well. Here we have a family member, Malin Aegirion. And here we have Vaymaris Aegirion, family member. Their bodyguard is the Dragon Bodyguard Cavalry. Okay. Same bodyguard for all of them, probably. They have some units. The Valyrian Heavy Bowman. Valyrian Heavy Pikeman. Valyrian Steel Bowman. Looking good. I like Peaman's work on Valyria and the map here. So I remember when he improved Westeros 1.0 by adding Essos, etc. I thought Essos were kinda not as good looking as the rest of the mod because the Westeros part had much more detail. But Peaman was a newbie. He had never done any map changes before. In this mod he has clearly been improving his skills with the map because this area looked really cool. And detailed, not just flat terrain, but actual lot of hills and cool stuff. Very much detail. I like details. If it was just flat terrain, it wouldn't look very impressive. So the more detail on the map, the better. Okay, and especially when it's improving on a map that is already very detailed, then the rest of the map needs to be detailed too. I believe I can't use Photoshop or GIMP to improve the map. I would need to follow a guide and teach myself that. But I did learn how to do map changes in Warcraft Total War using the tool Geomod, I believe, that no longer works on my computer. I tried to use it a year ago or something and it refused to work. It refused to start. But when it worked in 2017 and 2018, I actually did create an entire area in Warcraft Total War named the Broken Isles between Eastern Kingdoms and Northrend. Because the old map with the Eastern Kingdoms, Kalimdor and Northrend looked so detailed, I didn't. In the end, I decided to scrap my work because I sucked at painting, you know. I could paint the continent, I could add stuff to it and such, but in the end it looked amateurish compared to the rest of the world, so that's why I decided to scrap it. And that's also why I thought that the new area of Essos in Fire and Blood looked worse than the rest of the map, because it wasn't as detailed. But this map is clearly a lot better looking, and hopefully he will probably improve, if he hasn't done so already, I don't know, improve his Essos in Fire and Blood as well, because this Essos looks really cool. Okay, especially the Valyrian area. Okay, we have volcanoes and stuff. I don't even know if they can erupt, but I think so. There are that feature in Medieval 2. Okay, here we have Raymar Doraeris. Okay. We have Vaheron Doraeris as well. And Daemalar Doraeris. Okay. Ah, Doraeris. Not Doraeris, but Doraeris. Okay. So we have some troops here. We have the Valyrian Light Swordsman and Light Spearman. Can recruit some troops. Can recruit an envoy. So they look like this. This probably is an old picture. He looks different on this smaller portrait, the unit card. The unit info picture looks like one of the diplomats from Game of Thrones, Fire and Blood. Well, this one look different. I believe he probably looks like this in when he is recruited, and only looks like this now because it's an outdated picture. But I could be wrong, because the model is not the same on both pictures. We have the Valyrian Lightbowman recruited here, Spearman, Swordsman, Pikeman, all of them light. So as we know, there exists medium versions of all of them as well, and heavy. And then we have some unique troops too, including the dragons and the mages and such. Okay. Aramian Valyrian. Okay, another general. And Teraemon Valyrian. Here we have some troops. We have the Valyrian Fire Mages. Oh, so we start with some mages here. Valyrian Fire Mages, really cool unit. And Valyrian Heavy Swordsman, so some heavy troops. Over here we have Regal Nohenius. Regal Nohenius, okay. And Aegaron Nohenas. Okay. And inside of the settlement we have Rahalon Nohenas. Okay. Some basic troops can be recruited. We have Valyrian Smiths here, another unique unit. And Dragon Lords, they look really cool. Valyrian Swordmasters, they look like this, okay. Valyrian Swordmasters. We have some ships here. Oh, it's a new model. Thought the ship models would just be the same as in Fire and Blood and Game of Thrones Enhanced, but with different banners. That was wrong. We can clearly see that this ship has a dragon symbol in the front. It's a new model, same style, but with the dragon in the front there. Really cool. We have the hero here, Aegon Targaryen. So Aegon Targaryen is playable. The original Aegon that conquered Westeros. He has the same bodyguard as the others. Inside of this city we have Aerion Targaryen. Aerion Targaryen, okay. Also get Outriders here. The lack unit info card. Okay. We have another hero, Aemon Targaryen. He has the same model as our Aegon Targaryen in Game of Thrones Enhanced. He has the Malfoy portrait. So the actor of Malfoy from Harry Potter looks like a Targaryen. See if it. Okay. And then Valyrian Light Macemen available here. It's a garrison. We have Mahanar Raylan. Sorry. Mahanar Raylanis family member. Okay, inside of that settlement. And then we have Iradar Raylanis over here. Had quite a few heroes. In this city we have Yehadar Kainitias. And a cool unit, Valyrian Blood Mages. So the other mage unit looks like this, really cool unit. And we have Rayhaven Kainitias. Rayhaven Kainitias, okay. Same board guard as the others. Here we have Rayhamix Belarius. Okay, and here's the Mounted Dragon Lord unit. The garrison as well. And Vagal Belarius. Vagal Belarius. Vagal Belarius. Belarius. Vagal. Vagal Belarius. Okay. Sometimes it can be hard to pronounce the names. Okay, Valyrian Heavy Maceman. Heavy Spearman. And the general Salenis Belarius, okay. Here's the faction heir, Daemadar. And faction leader, Viserainar. Oh, we can even get small dragons from the capital of Valyria. So we access the small dragons at the start. They're really good. Okay. I wonder what the difference is between the small dragons and the others, if they are visibly much smaller or if they're not. Fuck, it crashed. Okay, see you soon. Back, so the game crashed. By the way, we'll check sound. They have no sound. Now we have sound. Clicking stuff, and we can hear the ambient sounds. There are no sounds when we click on the troops, so maybe Peaman didn't want them to say anything. That's fine, so he's pretty much removed the vanilla voices. So the game crashed when we clicked on the capital of Valyria and clicked on this guy, Viserair, faction leader. When I right clicked on him to check his details, or if I clicked when I clicked on his bodyguard to see his bodyguard, then it crashed. Okay, so I've seen this portrait before. Okay, so the game can crash if we click on certain buttons, I believe. Okay, to go foul. Let's check the rest of the map. This is a preview video, so we want to check all the areas. You can see that Valyria is pretty vast here. You can zoom in to see more in detail, but then the map is kind of out of place, just like in Game of Thrones Enhanced, by the way. So the zoomed in map do not work properly, just like in the other mods, but when it's outzoomed it's fine. And the map is huge, Peaman is clearly using all regions, all the 199 regions I believe. There are some rebel areas down here, uninhabited. So we have some factions here. This is the area of the city Shadow. Shadow Lord of Ash, I actually see that they have some unique models too.
Only my liege, no other.
Yeah, Shadow broke. Oh, he had some voice lines too. So the voices are not entirely removed. I was wrong. But we can see that it's entirely custom on the map. Up here we have the Prince of the Hidden City. And then we have an area here. Dreadlord of the Bloodless Men are holding this strip of land. Dreadlord of the Bloodless Men. And we have a bunch of rebel territory here. A small area. It's the sea. Here's also the sea. So the Orange Chariots are sea, okay. We have God Emperor of GT, clearly inspired by China. And the God Empress of Leng, probably inspired either by Taiwan or Japan. Or Korea. But this area is probably China, and this is either Taiwan or Japan. Okay, then we have some rebel areas. We have this isle too. Emperor of Great Moraki. They are not Asians, so they are a different faction. Entirely. Their cities look like they are probably Asian. Their cities look Asian to me. But they have a different look compared to the others. Empress look more like Chinese. The emperor here also looked Chinese. Maybe Taiwan and China are the inspiration. And then these guys are different. Mongol inspired, right? Maybe. Okay, here we have the tribe of Sotorius. Okay, and they hold this area. So they are like tribes. Okay. Here we have the Summer Isles. The princess of the Summer Isles. So the jungle tribes over here. Holding a bunch of isles. Okay, and then we have this area. The Giscari Empire. Dominant faction, they have really cool strat-model cities, and their units look kinda cool on the map. Especially their cities, I think, look cool. With the harpy here. Giscari Empire, they are probably the harpy cities, and they're an empire. Okay. Really cool faction, we can see how large they are huge. The map, they remind me of probably the ancient Mahirian or whatever empire in Empire Total War, the Indian Empire bordering China and such. They were conquered by Britain. Okay, then we have here we have the city states of Mother Roin. And the Magister of Kuhor. And further east we can see that we have the let's see what they are named. Kingdom of Andals here. Rebels is just a rebel area, okay. Here we have a faction with the bear. Looks somewhat similar to, I believe it's the Russian bear, Novgorod or something, I'm not sure. Bearded Priests of Norvos is the faction. Here we have the city-states of Sarnar. And here we have the Dothraki, new, completely new strat models. Yeah, it's impressive all the work Peaman has done. So he made a map from scratch, basing the mod first on Fire and Blood, then changing the map to have a focus on Essos with only a few areas of Westeros in the mod. So this part of the Martell homeland. We have currently House Martell here, but they will be replaced with a minor house. They are more prominent during this time, so they won't be Martell when the mod is released. I believe they are still to be changed. So currently they are Martell, but there will be another house. We have House Durandon here, you probably will get a different banner, unless their banner is exactly like the Baratheon banner. I don't know their history. Okay, and we have the Arryn faction. There will be a different house, House Royce, I believe, one of the smaller minor houses of House Arryn in Game of Thrones. They were more prominent during this time period, so they will be House Royce. Runestone is their seat of power. Then we have this area, currently named as House Bolt, but you can see that the banners of the Frip has been changed, and that the banners of the settlements and the units are still to be changed. They will be House Frost, I believe. An ancient Norton house, even older than Bolton. Okay, so Bolton and Martell will be changed before the release, and Arryn, well, maybe they will get a different symbol. I don't know the symbol of House Royce. I know that House Royce and House Frost will be added, replacing Arryn and Bolton. And that we will have two other houses than Martell. I believe here we have one house, Durandon, but they will probably have a different symbol. And then Martell will also be changed. Okay, so there are some stuff that Peaman will want to do before releasing it publicly, but it's impressive that he turned the map from Fire and Blood into this map with a focus on Essos, then he added all the factions through coding. It's not that difficult to do. And then the creation of the map is what I would have problem doing, but adding the factions to the map is kind of easy. It will take some time, a few hours, but then he has actually added unit models to all of the factions. That's the really impressive feat there. And then not only the battle models, but also added all the details on the map, and added the strat models. Both all the agents have been added, and all the generals, etc. And even cities on the map have been changed. Now, not all cities have been changed, because it's not possible. If you change too many strat model cities on the map, you will get a lot of issues in the mod. I believe there is a limit on how many you can have. That's why some of them are still vanilla. But he changed all the ones that he could change. And then, I might be wrong, because in his Fire and Blood mod, he changed probably every settlement. But I believe in Warcraft World War and in other mods, when I try to replace every strat model city with a different one, I believe that at one point the game became very unstable, so when you exited it would crash and such. After battles it would crash and such, but maybe he has found a way to not have that issue, I don't know. But the impressive thing is that he has edited the models and or rigged models himself, so a lot of the models are new for this mod. So as I said, not all the city models have been changed, but all the agents of units and diplomats, assassins, spies, etc. have been changed. Okay, and then I also think he has added unique models for some custom characters too, is also a nice touch. Okay, so this is Rise of Valyria Total War. So if I'm gonna play this mod in the future, I will play Valyria, or the Valyrian Freehold. There are a bunch of rebel areas we can conquer here. I don't know about stability in battle, or stability and clicking and turn, but the mod is clearly looking impressive. We can't walk that far either each turn, so the map is huge. Yeah, very huge map. Okay. It would be good with a battle. Question is, should I fight a battle in the campaign? Should I exit and start a quick battle?
My enemies fear me. Do you? Yes.
There is no music in the mod. That's something that needs to be changed. Maybe add vanilla music at least. I could probably do that, that's easy, but otherwise new music would be nice, but I don't know what music. Throw music or something else, I don't know. Okay, so this is the campaign of Rise of Valyria. Quit game. Yeah, we can quit. Oh, there is music here. So we will silence the music right now because I don't want to ruin it by having music playing. Okay. Custom battle. Fire and blood. Maximum resources. So the Valyrian Freehold. Faction with the Blood Elven looking. The Blood Elf looking symbol. Same faction. And the enemy should be the Kiskari Empire. Pick units. I don't know if they're using any dragons. I'm not using the medieval tutor lore engine overall project tool or the M2TV EUP tool. And without that tool, I'm afraid that dragons could crash the game. Not sure. We could try, but there is a risk they will crash the game if I use the dragons. Well, we will try. Take a mounted unit. We'll demand the Dragon Lord as this faction and we'll pick our army. Monstrous dragon, small dragon, large dragon, and huge dragon. I want to check them. The Lord could be leading the army. Actually, not the Lord, the bodyguard. Dragon bodyguard, of course. And we have some heavy cavalry, light cavalry, mounted dragon lords in the army as well. We will not have the dragon lords, they're probably the same as the bodyguard. Okay, we'll add some other units. The Valyrian medium cavalry. Valyrian heavy longbowmen. Heavy bowmen. Steel bowmen. Medium longbowmen. We don't need more long-range units. Go for some spearmen, the heavy spearmen. Actually, we could remove... no, we won't remove them. Heavy spearmen, heavy pikemen. Dragon lords. Valyrian swordmasters. Okay. Valyrian smiths. Valyrian firemage temple guard. Need the medium and light troops there. Heavy longbowmen, heavy bowmen. Don't need a medium longbowmen. Remove medium stuff and light stuff. Okay. Heavy swordsmen, of course. They're cool. Fire mages, blood mages, heavy macemen, yeah, we rather use that than the swordsman. And then there's medium and light troops, we will use the heavies if we can. Then their enemy, the Kiskari Empire. Okay, they will have, I believe, cavalry is their leading unit. More cavalry, we have some heavy cavalry, medium cavalry, light cavalry, heavy long bowmen, heavy bowmen, lockstep bodyguards, ah that's their bodyguard, we'll add them as the bodyguard, lockstep legions, he's got his slave soldiers, heavy spearmen, heavy long spears, heavy swordsmen, heavy axemen, Sons of the Harpy, of course. We will add the 4 units of elephants. And they will have some siege engines too. Counter the dragons. Okay, let's start the game. The battle. So the text is still all Robert's broken field with Iron Throne. Oh, fuck, it crashed. Okay, as far as I can see, there are one or two units or whatever causing a crash when we try to play that battle. Don't know if it's the elephants, the dragons, or one of the other units. But I believe that Peaman will need to try out each unit individually to see that they work, because we couldn't play a custom battle without a crash. Okay. But I will try a quick battle instead. Okay, see you soon. Hello, I tried to play a quick battle, it also crashed. So quick battles and custom battles seem very unstable. So we could start a campaign and play a battle, but I'm pretty happy with this video now. We've taken a look at the faction rosters in custom battle, we've checked out the map. The only thing that we haven't done is actually play a campaign battle or a custom battle battle. So the custom battles and the quick battles crashed. And in the campaign we could probably play battles, but I haven't done so. The enemy was far away from our troops. Okay, and I think we have already previewed this video enough. It's pretty long already. Okay, so if I return to this mod, which I probably will do, then I will start a campaign as the Valyrian Freehold and we will play battles there. But this will have to do as the preview video. We previewed the custom battles, we have previewed the campaign map, and we have taken a look at both the rosters and the settlements and the areas and everything. So this is Rise of Valyria Total War, a sister mod to Game of Thrones Fire and Blood, made by Peaman. Okay. And I'm Mr. Nyren. Thank you for watching. See ya.